Good morning, Los Angeles. It is a bright and sunny day in downtown. We are here back at our old favorite place, the metro station. Oh, we do love coming here, don't we? Yeah, the Halloween Horror Nights did take its toll on you a little.
I was waiting for you at the maze. All I could see was other people just coming out and being terrified by people in masks. And I was like, it's like my worst nightmare. Like, I'm watching it on TV, but I'm not.
We got over it. It was a lot of fun. Ash vs. Evil Dead was absolutely awesome. We did that twice. It was so good. And the Shining one was really good as well. And today we are going to head back to Hollywood for a little while, and we are going to do some tours of celebrity homes, because
trying to see some famous people.
We thought, what is the most tourist thing that can happen? And it's that. And we thought, yeah, let's do it. So we're going to go see some celebrity homes. Oh, look, it's Ben Affleck. We are now in Las Vegas.
Yay!
We are in Vegas and we've just stepped off the plane, and already there are slot machines. So you could just sit here the whole time for a couple of days and just play the slot machines and not have to go anywhere, because there's food places right over there. So kind of everything you need right here, as long as you don't sleep. But instead we've got a hotel, which I think is going to be much more comfy, and we should probably go and get to that now.
Look at how fancy all of this is. Look at it all. All of the gold.
And this is only the lobby. There's so much more. So much more. We're going to go and explore. So after taking one wrong turn and getting in the wrong lift, going up and down a few floors, we made it to our room, and we got an upgrade on our room because they didn't have any of the rooms that we actually ordered. So they put us in a bigger one, and now we've got all of this extra space and two beds that we can jump across. So we've got one bed there, another bed here, and I'm going to jump across from that one onto that one and back again all night long. Yeah, all night. No sleep. But I think the most impressive thing about this room is the damn view. Would you look at that? I mean, holy shit. For real. There's a damn roller coaster outside of the hotel. That's a goddamn roller coaster. On the middle of the Vegas Strip. Look at this, over here. Have you ever wondered where 90% of the use of electricity in America goes? It's probably here, to light this damn place. But for now, we are gonna go and find some cake. Isn't that right?
Yes. It's 11:30. And that is like 5 p.m. in normal time. I reckon we've still got a good few hours of buffet.
Mysteries that have plagued the minds of mankind for centuries.
What is existence? What does it mean to exist? What is a cronut? I'm about to find out. That is damn fine. That's the inside of the cronut right there. A birthday cake donut. That's got a little bit of everything happening in there. This is a cross between a croissant and a donut. And it's utterly insane. So good. You'll have to excuse my disheveled appearance as we've got up and headed out to find food in the morning. But look at the size of these damn pancakes. I think they are actually literally as big as my head. I don't know how Amber is going to get through her ones. So we've had a day of relaxing by the poolside for a little while, which was really nice. That was pleasant in the sun today, and it was a nice place to be for a little while just to chill out. But we're going around the Vegas Strip at the moment. We're just taking a walk down to see what there is. And this is where you're gonna start recognizing some similar sites. And we're about to go past the Bellagio, just up over here. Is a little bit of an understatement. Look at all of this in here. Look, do you know I actually heard that Caesar stayed here? True fact.
Whoa! Oh god! Oh! Oh no way! Hang on! What? Hotel, and as you can see above me, the sky has cleared up a bit, except it hasn't. This is all fake. It tripped me out a little bit because I walked under an archway, saw this and thought, oh, the sky has brightened up again, except it hasn't. It's still dark outside. It's light in here. It's always daytime. Don't stay in here too long or it'll mess your body clock up. But the most famous thing about the Venetian is that on the inside and gondolas that take you around the shops. This is all an entire shopping district. After moving on from the Venetian and all of that indoor weirdness that was messing up my head between day and night, we find ourselves outside of the Treasure Island Hotel. I would hope there's a lot of water stuff going on down there. It's Treasure Island.
I mean...
Oh, right. Oh, okay, over there. Yeah, I can see. I can see water stuff happening. I say the Treasure Island Hotel, is one of the famous hotels in
famous,
Vegas.
Yeah. Famous when you see it, you go, oh!
Yeah, famous because when you see it, you see that. But is it safe to say it's also famously tacky?
I don't know. Maybe.
Seems a little. Good afternoon on what is possibly the hottest day of us being out here so far. It is bloody bright. Can someone tell the weather that it's November now? Because it is nuts. We are at the... Where is it? Is it there? It's right there. We are at the Las Vegas sign. We have... So welcome to the fabulous Las Vegas. As if we weren't already in it. But now we're officially welcomed to it. So we're going to go and get a closer look at the sign. Maybe getting some shade behind it. Jesus. How hot are you, honestly? You're all right. You're toasty. I'm becoming a, what I like to call Drew Jerky. Drerky, for short. We did it. We made it. Las Vegas sign. Gabby? We did it. There it is. Smaller than you think it's gonna be, isn't it? This is a rather loud and rather bright, but equally famous Fremont Street, which is a street which is all undercover. One long street, completely undercover up here. If we're lucky at some point, we might see that there is a zip line that goes all the way from one end to another that you can literally fly across the ceiling on. What's your initial impression?
Loud.
There's a lot of stuff happening. It's a bit crazy. People are flying in here. It's crazy. I see you, Danny DeVito. I see you. If you get here in the day, but you wait a little while. All the lights, come on. All along Fremont Street. Everything lights up. There go some zip liners. All the way across. Now it's not just loud, it's loud and bright. So we're back at our hotel and we are in the casino area, and Amber is about to play a Wonder Woman game. You have $1 that I have very generously given to you. You have the $1. How do you feel? Lucky? All right, stick the dollar in.
Let's just do all of them.
All right, okay. You won. There you are, you're already up. There you go. See, look, you're up to $3 too now. You can literally cash out and be done now.
Boring. So I'll do another 100.
Okay. So you're going down now. What are you gonna do? You've broken even pretty much now.
I've got more than that. I started off with one.
Oh yeah, no, you've got like $2.15.
But I only get
$1.05 back. Yeah, because you spent the dollar on it. So you can cash out and have broken even.
I'm alright, that was your dollar. Should I do a risky
100? Could do. Risky 100? Oh. Boo.
You got 15 cents. 15 cent voucher. Hold that up. Hold that up. That's what you've got left from your dollar. It's 15 cents.
It wasn't even my dollar. It's your 15 cents.
You can keep it. It's fine. It's a gift.
Oh, that's so annoying. I was like a dollar fiver.
Yeah, see, this is the thing. Gotta quit while you're ahead.
I'm gonna do it again.
I'm all out of dollars, I'm afraid.